Tawhid, what does he mean?
Unity.
What does Tawhid mean?
Unity of God.
Unity. Yeah. To have a unity, is that meaning more than one, to be unified?
No.
Ah, so how can you have unity then?
One of the Ten Commandments, don't bow down to any graven image on the heavens or earth.
So why do Muslims bow down and kiss a rock?
I kiss my mum as well.
Yeah. He's just compared his mother to a rock in Mecca.
I am telling you, tomorrow might be too late.
Is Allah's knowledge eternal? Is Allah's knowledge living?
Yes.
Is the knowledge of Allah limited in any way? How is this not God? You've lost the debate, and you've lost the debate because all you do is listen to Golden Shower Boy over there.
I don't disagree with you.
But that's not in the Bible. In the Bible, Jesus clearly says that he's got a God.
Yeah. But again, you're
and he prays.
Yeah. But you know what the problem?
Oh, Father in heaven.
The problem that you Muslims have got.
No, it's not Muslims.
It's people. I'm just going to say a fact. A problem that Muslims have, and when they engage in these kinds of discussions, is that
they bring the Bible.
They have only got slivers of information because they learn about Christianity through the likes of Muhammad Hijab, rather than coming and talking with Christians.
No.
I stood here. You didn't come and talk to me.
I was too late
to talk to him, and then you started talking to me. You didn't come and find a Christian to talk to. So again, don't pretend that you're here to talk to me.
Whatever I found you, you found me. Yeah. Whatever you're saying doesn't make sense.
So, making sense. So the problem that Muslims generally have is that they take their information from the likes of Zaki and Ike and Ahmed Didad and Shabi Ali, and they don't actually sit down and study with Christians what the Christian faith is.
Okay, that's why I'm asking you.
So now we'll go to the New Testament.
Yeah.
I've shown you that the earliest Christians worship Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I showed you that. And just so
my question. So I had a question. My question was, why would Jesus pray to a God if he's God?
That is a fair question.
Thank you. To answer.
So you know that we Christians believe in the Trinity.
Yes.
And we Christians believe that the divine Logos, that is Jesus Christ, takes onto himself a human nature.
What are you dependent on?
Now, when he takes on that human nature, he is representing Israel. You've got to understand a lot about what the Bible teaches. It's backdrop, context, all of this. Yeah. I mean, and I can explore some of that with you, but very briefly, I'll just give you a brief synopsis. God establishes covenants through history. Establishes one with Adam, establishes one with Noah, then he establishes one with Abraham, then he establishes one with Moses. The one he establishes with Moses is the idea that a faithful Israel will meet a holy God. But then the whole story of the Old Testament is how Israel is not faithful. Thus it is short of the covenant promise. And there's no answer to this. In fact, the whole point of that was to demonstrate that human beings couldn't be holy as their Father in heaven was holy, and needed God. I'm answering his question. And so they need an intervention. And God provides that intervention. He becomes a man, and in Jesus Christ, a man, a holy, a faithful Israel meets a holy God. The Son has eternally spoken with the Father. Even before his incarnation. At his incarnation, he continues to speak to his Father. But now he's a human being, we call it prayer.
Do you believe that, Muslims?
So before he was on earth, was it like a separate man?
Who's going to sit on the throne?
Allow me to address the lady. So we as Christians believe that the divine unity, the divine essence, exists as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Always, before the incarnation.
So let me just give you an explanation and then how we can know that three is one and one is three. Because lots of people say, well, how can three be one and one be three? Well, you're standing in three-dimensional space right now. We have this dimension of space, we have this dimension of space, we have this dimension of space. These are distinguishable dimensions. We experience and feel things, we think of one form, and they are the same thing, essentially. But we can distinguish the three dimensions from one another. We don't confuse the horizontal with the lateral.
They're different.
So, exactly, thank you. They are distinct, but they are one, because each one is the same.
In what way one?
Are you studying space right now?
Yeah.
Do you experience it as three things or one thing?
sometimes cheating back in front.
No, you always experience it as three, even if you're not conscious of it, because you're a three-dimensional creature. You've got three dimensions, bro. So whether you're conscious of it or not, you experience space.
Okay, but we're talking apple and pear. Can we talk about?
So I was using that as an analogy to demonstrate that we can think of three as one and one as three. That's all I was demonstrating, is that this is not an illogical statement to make, because we experience.
Oh, well, it's logical on the three-dimensional thing. It's not very logical.
Thank you for accepting that it is a logical statement. Now, when we talk about God, we say that whatever God is, that thing that makes God God, the Father has it, the Son has it, and the Holy Spirit has it at the same time.
No, they don't.
Why are you trying to tell me my beliefs now as a Christian?
You're telling me that Jesus
Sorry. Did you just try to tell me my beliefs as a Christian?
I'm trying to understand what you're saying. Are you saying?
No, you said no, they don't. So you're trying to tell me my beliefs, or are you trying to ask me my beliefs?
Tell me what you said. Tell me what you said.
Okay.
What did you say?
So let me say it
again. Gentlemen, calm down.
I like
the conversation.
Just keep it.
I can do conversations where people are polite. So as Christians, we believe that thing, whatever that thing is, we call it an essence.
The creator.
We call it a substance. That thing that God is, the Father has it completely, the Son has it completely, and
it doesn't though.
So you're telling me my beliefs.
God doesn't pray to God.
One second. Are you telling me my beliefs? You asked me about what I believe.
From what you said before. It doesn't make sense what you're saying now.
Of course, because you're here to prove a point.
Explain to me. And it doesn't exist in your mind either. You're not sure.
No, I'm completely sure of it.
You're not sure because you've just told me
you've gone from. Hold on a second. No, I haven't. You've gone from telling me what my beliefs are to now telling me what my emotional state is. Are you a prophet? Should I be sitting here writing notes because you're a prophet? Is God speaking to you now? Is God speaking to you now?
Okay, give me a third story then.
No, give me a third story. I haven't changed at all.
Give me five stories. Bob,
this is where I start shouting. Come on.
We need to keep him calm.
Yeah, let's keep him calm.
This is where I...
Would you like some water?
No, no, I've got some. Thank you. Would you like some water?
No, I have. Look.
Okay, brilliant. Great. We're all good for water.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's coming. So my point to you, bro, is what would be better, right? Muslims like to call themselves students of knowledge.
I've never called myself that.
Muslims like to talk about themselves as being students of knowledge. I know Muslims. You might not, but maybe that says something about your pride.
I'm telling you what I've heard Muslims say. Tell me the first.
Okay,
tell
me something.
Can you go again?
So don't tell me what I believe if you don't like to be told what you believe.
No, I didn't say it was about your belief. I said what I heard Muslims say.
Okay.
You've got to keep up with this conversation, bro.
I'm trying to keep up with your three gods.
You've just said, I believe in three gods.
Yes.
Can you show me anywhere in this Bible that teaches that?
No.
I agree.
Nowhere.
Do I believe in this book?
I hope so.
So if we all agree that this book doesn't teach a belief in three gods, and you all agree that I believe in this book, why do you think I believe in three gods?
Because you keep saying that's the question.
And you know what the answer to that is, sister? The answer is you're wrong.
Okay, I'm
thinking
gods.
I believe in three gods.
No.
That's the answer to the question.
How many gods?
I will be generous. Look, listen. He might think, because he says the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, they are all same and they're all equal. So is the Father okay? Is the Father God? Mighty God, the Creator.
My question is,
he the Father?
God
it is. But God. Jesus is not. According to him, Jesus is not the Creator. He doesn't create. He didn't create. He's been the Father. He created Jesus. That's how we believe. That's
okay.
The Holy Spirit. We not even go there.
But that's not what we believe. That might be what you say we believe, but that's not what we believe.
Do you believe the Father is the Creator?
Do you believe Jesus has been created by God?
What would help you?
Do you believe the Father is the Creator?
What would help you, brother? And what would help you, brother, is if you actually approach this conversation with some humility.
We're trying.
And recognize the fact that you don't know as much as you think you do about what we believe.
Teach us, please.
Right, okay. So what would help?
in this teaching moment is for you not to prescribe beliefs to me that I do not have.
Okay.
No.
But when you change your study,
I have not changed it one iota. You've just not been listening.
If something you utter, it doesn't make sense, we have to stop and
we can discuss that. But that is very different from a prescribing belief to me, like he has.
Okay, I will vote for him.
It's his belief, and we respect
him. Okay, right.
We respect
him. Right. Well, I don't think it is.
No, we don't.
So, let's have a look at this. We all agree.
Yes.
Every one of us agrees that this book doesn't teach belief in three gods.
Yes.
And you all agree
that I believe
in this book.
Yes.
So, logically,
you don't believe in three
what
gods.
What makes more sense? That I don't believe in three gods, or that you are wrong about believing that
yes,
I do?
Yes, yes.
Which makes more sense?
It makes sense. Good.
So are we all agreed that it makes more sense that you're wrong in thinking that I believe
in three gods? Yes,
he is.
I apologize.
You believe in one God?
We did apologize. Okay.
Now I'm going to show you where Jesus Christ creates something.
Okay.
So are you listening?
We're not asking about that.
We're going to use the Bible to show that Jesus Christ is the creator.
Yeah, Quran as well as confirmed that Quran says Jesus, he creates a bird from clay, but with the power of God, with the permission of God.
Now let's compare that to what the Bible says.
Okay.
Now I need to read two passages to you.
Yes.
Yeah. They're quite long passages. Bear with me. Yeah. Okay.
But you believe in the same token that Jesus prayed to the Father?
Yes, we do. Do you believe
in the same token the Father never prayed to no one?
So let me, one second.
No. It's important. The Father did never pray to no one.
One second. Let me address the question. Okay. Because I don't think you were listening before. That's fine. And you've discussed before. I know that sometimes you don't necessarily listen to what I'm saying.
Could be.
In terms of, like, I think the sister heard it the first time. Before the incarnation, the Father spoke to the Son, and the Son spoke to the Father. This is before the incarnation. We believe this. Yeah? Right? And a prayer, what is a prayer? The English word to pray is to supplicate. It's to ask someone for something.
Yes.
Or ask someone to do something.
To save him from the crucifixion, for example.
To do something. Exactly. Except that Jesus' prayer at that point was to do the will of the Father.
It was rejected.
No.
Yeah.
No. Again, you are misrepresenting the Bible to make
it
catchphrase.
Was accepted.
Yeah, you're making a cliche.
Wait, one second. Wow. Did Jesus pray?
What was the prayer?
The prayer was to save him from the crucifixion.
No, the prayer was to do the will of the Father. Let me show you.
It's always the will of the Father, no matter what prayer you pray.
Thank you. So that's what his prayer was.
Always.
Thank you.
It's always the will of the Father. Jesus, Moses, Muhammad, everyone pray. Every human being pray.
Catchphrase.
At the end of the day, is always the will of the Father.
Okay. Except that Muhammad never did the will.
But what was the prayer for?
So.
Yeah. Why? Why would he pray? If he what was
the prayer? Address one point at a time.
Yeah. No. You'll go back. Yeah, okay.
No.
We're out from Gethsemane.
Okay.
We are out from Gethsemane now. Now we are.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Because this is where we were before you tried to drag us into Gethsemane with your.
Oh, the prayer. I was saying, I was just saying Jesus prayed to the Father, but the Father never prayed to him.
No. Hold on one second. The Father speaks to the Son, and the Son speaks to the Father. The Father asks the Son to do things,
but he never asks.
And the Son asks the Father to do things.
But the Father never asks.
Prayer is supplication.
He orders.
So if the Father asks the Son to do something,
he never asks him to
that is supplication. If the Son asks the Father to do something, that is supplication. So, now, let's go back to this.
That doesn't make sense. Do you understand that doesn't make sense?
No, it really does.
It doesn't make sense.
What does prayer mean semantically?
Okay, do I pray to you when I say, let's go and get a coffee?
Actually, that is prayer, yes.
Let me give you an example.
I'm going to demonstrate your ignorance of the English language now.
Okay.
Is English your first language?
No, I'm French.
So English is not your first language? Is it your first language? Is it your first language? Right, okay.
I speak six languages.
When the Queen... So what? I speak two.
Six languages. Maybe my third language.
Whereabouts? Go and watch this yourselves on YouTube. When the Queen comes to do the speech in the House of Lords to open Parliament,
she prayed.
The very first words
going to make you look a fool now.
Okay.
The very first words that she says to the lords is, I pray ye lords be seated. So literally, if you said to me, let's go for a coffee right now, yes, that can be described as prayer. Because the Queen literally says in the House of Lords, I pray ye lords be seated.
Okay, okay. Maybe English is not my first language.
Exactly. However, English is not your
however,
first language.
It's not. Is it the same? Is it the same kind of prayer when I say, let's go have a coffee, apparently that's a prayer to you. Or is it the same, sir? Please save me, please my Lord, save me. That's not the same kind of prayer we're talking about. I'm not English, but that's not the same kind of prayer.
No, hold on one second. If you ask me to do something,
yeah, like,
and if you
I borrow money
God
from you,
to do something,
I beg you, give me £5, that's maybe it's a prayer.
The difference is that, the difference, what do you mean, what is the difference?
Exactly, you've not thought you through, you've not thrown through your logic.
It's not the same
point. The only difference,
it's like the same thing with
the only difference, the only difference is the person that we're asking of.
Yeah, exactly.
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 There's
but
one
the action of you asking and the action of you asking me or the action of you asking
okay,
God
who are you gonna,
is the same.
Who are you going to ask for
the only difference
your life?
Is who we're
God.
Asking.
No one else.
But that's based on ability. If you come to me and say, lend me a fiver, I might be able to lend you a fiver.
Yeah.
But if you say, lend me £1 million, I definitely can't lend you £1 million. But if you ask a multimillionaire to
this
lend you a quid,
Jesus doesn't
he
ask
might be
the
able
to.
To
save his life. Jesus asked God to
Bro,
save his life.
You're sunk, mate, on this argument. Just let it go.
No, you got
yes,
it.
Jesus
you got
it.
No, you got it. Listen,
a child could understand what I'm saying, but you're not
going to. Elijah, Masapatan, he was in the crucifixion already. Jesus was on the cross, and he was saying, why have you abandoned me, basically?
Yes, yes.
Elijah, Masapatan, in Aramaic.
Yes.
God the Father, he will never say that to Jesus.
I wonder.
God the Father doesn't need nobody.
I wonder.
He doesn't need no one, but Jesus needs the Father.
At what point Muslim critics of the Christian faith will actually engage with the fact that we Christians believe in the incarnation?
No, because
you try to criticize the Trinity and you always
because you make the Father and
the incarnation
equal.
All of your arguments.
I'm not even criticizing. Right, I don't understand. Sorry, let me
finish my point. Yeah, because you don't like me shouting. And I would prefer not to shout. But I will shout if I need to.
Yeah.
So, in terms, and it ruins his microphone. Please, spare the cameraman. It costs him a fortune. So, in terms of the all of these criticisms about Jesus dying on a cross, Jesus praying to the Father, all of those criticisms,
they are
fair criticisms, but that means that you honestly have to engage with the answer, which Muslims here in the park never do, because the answer is always the same,
which is
the incarnation. When Christ the Logos becomes a man, he's not going to become an atheist, is he?
He's not going to become
an atheist, because if anyone knows that the Father exists, it's the Son.
Amen.
So he's going to speak to his Father as a man, even though he did it in
the Bible?
Because then you mentioned about the cross.
I'll show you a verse as well.
The thing is, as Christians, we believe that what died on the cross was the human flesh, the human nature. We agree with Muslims. The divinity does not die. You go to the Council of Ephesus and the writings of the Council of Ephesus, the correction given at the Council of Ephesus is the idea that the divinity does not die.
Okay.
It's like me getting me an iron rod and a wooden stick and chucking them both into the water. One floats over the top, one sinks to the bottom. Why? Same action, same event,
like you,
but because of the nature of the things, they behave differently.
Okay.
So on the cross, the humanity dies, but the divinity does not.
What do you mean humanity dies?
And that's what the Bible teaches.
What do you mean humanity dies?
That's what the Bible teaches.
Okay.
Okay, so now, back to this point that I was going
the prayer,
to make.
Okay, the prayer.
No,
the prayer,
we've dealt with the prayer.
No, we don't.
No,
We're now showing
about Jesus Christ being the creator. So I'm going to read two passages.
Okay. Can you read the passage where they say you can't do nothing without?
Yeah, I can't do nothing without you.
Can you read that one?
Yeah,
we're
going to read myself can do nothing.
Is that the one? Thank you.
I agree. Jesus Christ,
only with the
in his humanity,
even Peter,
always
so
does what he sees
Peter,
the Father doing.
Even Peter, he was testimony of that as well.
Yeah,
says,
but again your snippet verses are not real students.
With the permission of God.
In the Bible,
but the thing is, Is my theology, is my theology as a Christian taken from the snippet verses used by the Dawah team? Or is it taken from reading the whole of the scripture?
We are doing the same.
When Muslims read the Quran, they use all of the Quran or just some of the Quran?
I'm telling you, Jesus said he can't do anything by himself.
Yes, and then you take
and now you're
going to
read something that he's done something. So you're doing exactly the same.
Then you take these verses and you balance them in the harmony of the whole.
Let's weigh the both. You saying Jesus says himself in the Bible, Jesus himself with the red letter, actually from his own mouth, says, I by myself can do nothing. Tell us why Jesus himself with the red letter said, I'm God, worship me, or I create this, or I give you this, or I am this.
He said, you're going to
okay.
And he will find someone else saying about Jesus, not Jesus himself. And he say accusing us of choosing passages.
So, what else are you going to read? So, there's going to be more.
Firstly, I don't have to jump through your hoops.
No,
you said, you said, show me the red letters.
No, not red letters.
You're, then you're going to go to.
Jesus
no, let, right. Do I have to shout?
Because Jesus
or are you going to let me speak? Okay. Or do I have to raise my voice?
Please don't.
Right, then you have to let me speak, bro. Okay?
He's angry.
Please. No, not angry, but I've just learned that in these kinds of contexts, sometimes this brother gets a little excitable, starts to lose control of himself, and I have to raise my voice to get my voice.
You have a right to remind me.
So, firstly, my theology is dependent on the whole of the Bible, not just the bits that you want me to use. So let's read this. God, after he spoke long ago to the fathers and the prophets in many portions and in many ways, in these last days has spoken to us in his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the world. Through whom he made the world. So the Father creates through the Son.
It was the way.
That is what the Bible teaches. That is what the Bible teaches. It might not be what the Dawah team tell you, but that is what the Bible teaches.
It's got nothing to do with the Dawah team.
Let's go back to Jesus saying, I am God, worship me.
Yes.
That was one thing.
That's cool.
Yeah?
Okay.
I'm going to show you where Jesus calls himself God.
Heavily if you find this.
Yeah, I'm going to show you. Didn't take me very long.
Okay.
Right.
Which passage reference, please?
Yes, John chapter 5. Verse 22. Did you get that?
Yes.
Have you added that to your notes?
No, it's in my head.
Yeah, you're going to study it when you go home?
Yes.
Brilliant. Did you get that?
Yeah.
John 5:22. John 5:22. Yeah. Listen to this. Not even the Father judges anyone, but he has given all judgment to the Son, so that all will honor the Son, even as they honor the Father. Right. So you honor Jesus Christ like you honor Allah. So you don't do it then.
No.
Now listen.
I honor my mom, my father. Yeah.
Brilliant.
I honor Muhammad.
Brilliant. Now listen carefully to what Jesus said. Listen carefully to what Jesus said. I'm going to insert the word Allah to replace Father, so you can hear the full significance of what Jesus said. Because we all agree that the Father of the Bible is equivalent to Allah. Listen.
Yeah.
For not even Allah judges anyone, but he has given all judgment to the Son, so that all will honor the Son,
who speaks
even as they honor Allah.
That's not Jesus
Allah.
Speaking.
That is Jesus speaking. It's in the red letters. The very thing he asked me to show him, where Jesus said, I am God, worship me, in the red letters. I've just shown you in the red letters.
Are you telling me now? Are you telling me now? Are you telling me that now Jesus says this, and then he says somewhere else.
Honoring God. Well, first of all, honoring somebody doesn't mean worshipping him.
So,
honoring somebody. I honor my mom. You can still worship her.
No, you can't. Now,
I honor my mom.
You seem rattled, guys.
No. Bob, it's not fair. You said, I will give you a passage where Jesus said, worship me.
Hold on, one second.
Did he say that or no?
Hold on, one second.
He's on the camera.
Yes.
Did he say that?
Can I answer?
Yes,
right, are we all listening?
Yes.
Because once again, I have to give you a lesson in the English language.
Again.
Oh dear! Once again, I have to give you a lesson in the English language. Now, I have taught English as a foreign language. I did it when I was in Colombia, so you're literally talking to someone who's in English.
There we go. Are you listening? Right, because we are speaking to two people who know so much about what Christians believe and so much about what I believe. Yeah, and all Christians. They are going to tell me where the word worship comes from. Where does the word worship come from? Shall I tell you the history of the word worship? Okay. The word worship. Are you listening? You're going to miss your English lesson here. This is really interesting stuff. I'm educating you.
I didn't even know Jesus was English.
I'm educating.
I didn't even know that.
Are you listening?
Wow.
He's not listening.
I really didn't know Jesus
speaking
English.
Are you listening?
Yes. Go ahead.
Okay. So the word worship comes from the word we are skipping. It's from the Middle English.
Middle English.
It's like, it's not Anglo-Saxon English. Yeah. It's the Middle English before our current English.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's an old thing. And what it means is to give due honor. Everybody say to give due honor.
To give due honor.
Due honor.
Due honor.
Due honor.
Middle English.
Are you listening?
Do you worship your own parents?
Are you listening?
Do you worship your own parents?
Are you listening?
Guys,
listen.
Do you worship your own parents,
listen,
your mom and your
listen.
Father?
Hey.
Listen! 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 Right. So let me give you an example. Because he doesn't know the use of the word English. He doesn't know that one of the titles of a judge in the court is his worshipness.
Yes, it is.
Why would he be his worshipness? Why can you address a judge in a court as his worship?
To honor him.
To honor him. Exactly. So we can honor our mothers and fathers. We can honor one another. And
I can pray to him for a coffee.
No, wait. You got it.
Can I finish? And we can honor God.
So in the same way?
No, not in the same way.
Why not?
Not in the same way. But now you've helped me prove my point.
Why you change?
Listen, I've sunk you. Listen. Now he sunk me. He said, but not in the same way. And I agree. So listen to what Jesus said. Jesus said, so that all will honor the Son, even as they honor the Father. We win, you lose. Thank you very much.
Do you honor your mum and your father?
Yes, of course I do.
Same way.
No, not the same way I worship God. No,
no worship, honoring God.
These words are interchangeable. Did you not listen to the English lesson?
English lesson.
This is an English lesson.
You says worship.
John 5:22.
Not honor.
What does worship mean?
Worship is to pray.
No, we are skipping. No, that's prayer. You don't know English, bro. Prayer means supplication. We are skipping means to give due honor.
You need to speak old English.
You've already admitted you don't know the history of the language. You've already said that English is in your first language.
We didn't even know Jesus spoke English.
But suddenly now they're scholars of the English.
We didn't even know Jesus spoke English.
So,
we didn't even know that.
You've just made your problems worse. Because the word honor is the word doxa. It's where we get orthodoxy from.
Orthodoxy
means right worship.
Right worship. Right worship.
So the word here is worship, because it's the word doxa in the Greek. So you're wrong in English, you're wrong in the Greek, and yet they still think they're right.
Do they use the word worship?
Means pray.
Do they use the word worship?
This means pray.
So I want you to deal with the point.
No.
Use the word worship.
Did that mean pray to Jesus?
So listen. No, wait. I have answered your questions multiple times. You need to answer my question.
Yeah.
Would you honor a prophet in the same way that you honor Allah?
No.
Yes. But Jesus says, honor me as you honor Allah. Why would he do that?
That's not Quran. That's not Quran.
It's not the Quran. But we were never talking about the Quran. You said, show me in the Bible. I'll show you in the Bible. And now he's saying, but that's not the Quran. That's not how we got to John 5:22.
You mentioned Allah.
Bro, just accept. You don't know what you're doing. You've lost the debate. And you've lost the debate because All you do is listen to Golden Shower Boy over there rather than actually study the Bible with Christians.
That's not Jesus teaching to
so,
give people's name.
I want you to deal with this.
Jesus never teach you to give Jesus people's said, name. Don't give people's
tell me this,
name.
Tell me this. Jesus says, one second. Jesus says, honor him as you honor the Father. Will you do that?
No.
Why?
Jesus said, God's Jesus Father. Said,
and
Jesus,
answer the question.
Jesus said, I'm not like the one that sent me. Jesus said, I am not like the one that sent me.
Exactly.
End of story.
The Father is not the Son.
And the Son
is not the Father.
The Bible says, God is not a man. And no, yet, you says God is a man.
No, you misquoted the passage.
No, no, misquoted again.
It says,
because you don't know English.
It said, should I
because
lie?
I don't know English.
We don't like
know
a man. That's what it says. You misquoted it. Heavens or earth. This is why I have to raise my voice. Because of excited, butthurt Muslims who don't like to lose an argument, even though the evidence is presented to them fairly and squarely. So, now, I've answered. I've been very charitable, and I've answered question after question from you. I want you to answer one of my questions.
No.
Jesus says you should. Jesus says that you should honor him as you honor the Father. Will you do that?
No.
Why not?
Because he's a prophet.
Because he's not God. So in other words, if Jesus said, honor me as you honor the Father, they acknowledge that Jesus just called himself God and worship me. Thank you very much.
I'll answer the question. Why we cannot abide by that? Because one of the ten
commandments. No one asked this question.
Shush.
You're interfering in my conversation.
Because you know why? You're going to be made quiet. You're
going
to be made quiet by your own book.
He said,
one of the ten commandments. Don't bow down to any graven image on the heavens or earth. Yeah. Where was that? Where is that? In the Bible. End of story.
So why do Muslims bow down and kiss a rock?
Yeah, that's a good question.
So why do Muslims bow down and kiss a rock?
He knows.
Kiss a rock.
Yeah, why kiss a rock?
I kiss my mom as well.
Yeah. He's just compared his mother to a rock in Mecca. Is that honoring your mother? You just compared a rock in Mecca to your mother.
You flip it.
How dishonorable.
You are dishonest.
Your mother deserves more respect.
Bow down, pray to the stone. And
your mother deserves more respect.
But killing somebody doesn't mean
respect. So,
your God praises God. Realize.
Don't bow down to any great image on the heavens.
Come
what
out.
Does that mean?
Yeah. So, fighting you to no, brother. Brother.
Yeah, yeah.
What you've done.
Neither the fishing is you.
You've misquoted scripture.
No, I haven't.
Your arguments are unconvincing. And let me explain why they're unconvincing.
I worship the God of Jesus.
One. They are unconvincing because you don't understand the words that you're using. They are unconvincing because you don't know the Bible you're quoting. They are unconvincing because you're attacking theology without an understanding of that theology. That's what you're doing.
I've asked you to make me understand. You haven't been able to.
Of course, because you started this conversation by saying that you could tell me what I believe. If the cup is full, you can't add anything into it. Exactly, so he's finished where he started. So in other words, he was never a student of knowledge. Show me where it says I believe in three gods in this book.
Jesus is God. You
show me.
You believe Jesus is God.
I believe in one God. I believe in one God.
Is it Jesus God?
Listen.
Is it Jesus God?
Yes.
Is the Father God?
Yes.
Is the Holy Spirit God?
Yes.
Is the Heavenly God?
Is the Haskaran the Quran?
What?
Is the Haskaran the Quran?
I don't believe
it. Answer. What about the Hafs? Is it Quran?
The Quran is not Hafs.
Which Quran? Hafs, Wash, Duri?
I'll answer.
Which Quran?
I'll answer.
Can I? Hafs, Wash, or Duri?
First of all, Quran is not written. Quran was Quran.
No, that's not my question.
Recitation.
Is the Hafs has the Quran?
Say must have.
Is the Hafs the Quran?
No.
Ask him again.
He just said the Hafs is not the Quran.
No,
there you go. So guys, he doesn't believe in the Hafs Quran. What about the Wash Quran?
Wash, Hafs is mashaf.
Wash and half. Wash and half. How many Qurans is that?
It's scripture.
How many Qurans is that?
One.
One. So when he says that half and wash equals one, that's okay. But if I say that the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are one, that's not okay. That's what he's just done. It's called double standard.
Double standard. You've made no case.
This
no
God
that we stand. Made no case. You've made no case, Miss Kim.
You yes, we have made a case.
You comparing
yes,
God.
We have made a case.
You comparing God and Jesus with halves and wash. Can you believe it?
It doesn't make sense. So are you suggesting that the halves and the wash are not the word of Allah?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying must
have. Oh, so they are the word of Allah.
But you says Quran.
Are they the word of Allah?
Do you know Quran?
Are they the word of Allah?
Do you know Quran what means?
Answer the question.
Do you know what is Quran mean?
Oh, yes, they are. Right. So if they are the word of Allah, can you say that they are not one of the attributes of Allah?
What do you mean attribute?
Because you just said,
is a part
I compared the half and the wash
is a
to
part,
God.
Is a
you believe that the half and the wash are the word of God.
Is a part of his knowledge.
So he says no. I don't think the Muslims know what they believe. I don't think the Muslims know what they believe.
God. You're trying to say, Quran is God, it's not God, Quran.
So it's an attribute.
You can give an attribute of
so
God.
So is Allah one or multiple? You just said that it, Allah's knowledge, it's Allah's knowledge, but it's not Allah. So is Allah one or not?
Allah is one.
So Allah is his knowledge then?
No, it's not.
Ah, so that's two then.
Allah is
your
teacher.
No.
You're a teacher.
Tawheed, what does he mean?
You're a teacher.
What does Tawheed mean?
Unity of God.
Unity. Yeah. To have a unity, is that meaning more than one, to be unified?
No.
Ah, so how can you have unity then?
Tawheed means one alone.
You said unity. Now you're changing it. Which story should I believe? The first one or the second one? What does Tawheed mean? One or unity?
I'm trying to go on your level to make you understand what means Tawheed.
You said Tawheed means unity. Then when I pointed out that you had to have a duplicity to have unity, you said it meant one. So who do I believe? Your first answer or your second answer?
Do you want to understand?
The second one. Right, because so Allah is one.
You clearly you don't understand Arabic.
Allah is one.
I'll give you the second one.
Let's deal with that.
Allah is one, unique.
Right, so he said, because you don't understand, I give
Allah
you the second one.
Unique.
So I actually think that Tawheed might mean unity.
No, it doesn't. No, just give you the second one.
Okay.
I said,
so now, Tawheed, now, let's look
one
at
one alone.
Right, fine.
One alone.
Fine, one alone.
Yes.
So, in what way is Allah one?
In any way, or shape
in
or
any
form.
Way, every yes. shape and form.
Yes.
So I can then say that Allah's word is Allah, and Allah's So now we've created a duplicity in the one.
Now you're mixing between his attributes.
Yes.
Yes.
With his oneness. With his oneness.
And his names.
Oh, hold on.
Yeah.
You said that the Quran is the knowledge of Allah, but that Allah's knowledge is not Allah.
Allah is not the knowledge, and
there
knowledge
we go.
Allah.
So that
like
means...
Allah says, you speak, you have a knowledge.
One second.
The knowledge is not Bob, and is Bob is not the knowledge.
Is Allah's knowledge eternal? Is Allah's knowledge living?
Yes.
Is Allah's knowledge... Is Allah, the knowledge of Allah limited in any way?
No.
How is this not God?
What do you mean it's not God?
How is that not God?
What do you mean how is not God? Because it's his nature.
Shall I tell you what you've got, bro?
His nature.
Shall I tell you what you've got?
So are you saying God by himself, eternal, but his knowledge, he took it upon him?
Shall I tell you what I'm saying?
What are you talking about?
Shall I tell you what I'm saying?
What are you talking about?
Shall I tell you what I'm saying?
And his knowledge...
Oh, he doesn't want to listen now.
Came along.
He doesn't want to listen now.
What do you mean about God?
He doesn't want to listen
now.
Shall I tell you what I'm saying?
What are you saying?
I am saying. Let's be calm, bro. I know you're rattled. I know you're up against the ropes. I know you're backed in the corner. But we can relax. I know you're backed up. But we can relax.
Come on, 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 come on He's
a liar, he's a Muslim!
He's a nice guy, but he doesn't know it. He's still aggressive.
Let's just go back to debating.
I'm telling you, tomorrow might be too late.
And that's my point, is that the actual... Exactly, and that's why it's irrational.
It
doesn't mean the power. I'm going to try and explain it to you. Try to keep up. The reason why it's irrational.
We've been doing it for the last 1400 years. Now we're here.
Yeah.
Now we're going to turn back.
And I'm understanding. I'm just talking back to you. Yeah, that's all right. Everyone's being filmed. So my point to you is, this is why it's irrational. If you say that Allah is absolutely one, right? That means you can't then introduce
the distinction
unless without compromising that oneness. Because you say that something is power without being Allah.
Because history is going to turn, so it's going to kill people.
Is eternality. Which means that oneness has a multiplicity within it. And that's the contradiction. Thank you for elaborating. It is a contradiction. Because on one hand you're saying that there is an absolute one. Just out of interest, do you know what the Tawhid means? Does it mean oneness or unity? To my knowledge, and I'm happy to be corrected if someone uses the evidence, but Tawhid means unity. Doesn't mean one. It means unity. But if you're saying unity, then that means a duplicity. Yeah, it is. I'm in the process of studying it, but the more I study it, the more problems I'm finding. Well, I mean, is that that's a different group of Muslims? I'm more familiar with Salafi. We're just keeping So my point is. So do you want to talk over here? Tell me what. How is the Sahari different from the Salafi? Just tell me what you know.
I'm just suggesting that so
I'm asking you to tell me what you know. What do you know that I need to know? Right, well, yeah, we didn't ask that. What I asked you was, If you're united or joined, that implies multiplicity. What is the United Kingdom? What is the United States? Well, you tell me what is united in your definition. Taweed, if I understand it, means unity. If I understand the word Taweed properly, and again, I'm open to correction, but it means unity. Would you agree if it does mean oneness?
You say unity means oneness.
I think that Taweed, when you look at the root of the word, it means unity. And unity implies multiplicity coming together. I just read it, you showed it me, and it said joined or united. Yeah. Unity and numbers are not the same thing. You're making a category mistake. You're confusing. You can explain most physical processes through mathematics, but the reality is if you look at anything that we explain with mathematics, it's always a combination of things. I have no idea. I don't work for him and he don't work for me.
Well, you have nothing to do with that.
No, we meet and work here. Yeah.
But that was off camera, right? Yeah. I know, but still, I'd rather not be rude.
Yeah. So, he was recording. And he has every right to record.
I know, but I asked not to be recorded.
Yeah. So, I mean, the thing is, you can't stand in a place where there's loads of cameras and then say, I don't want to be on camera. It's just not a reasonable request.
Yeah, for that last one, you can't blur it.
Yeah, we're not going to blur it when you were standing in the audience.
Yeah.
You chose to stand
there. Yeah, that's true. I just wanted to suggest
so, so my point is...
You're recording.
The contradiction...
Are you recording all the time?
Let me ask you this question.
I'm not having a discussion with you.
Let me ask you, so... Okay, let me just do a wrap-up with him, and if you want me and you can talk over at the railing. Yeah, all right?
Right, but what happened there before the Ajibaji? What happened there?
So basically, I was trying to approach Hijab Golden Shower, but he was in a debate with a sister, and then I got talking to some Muslims who may or may not be trying to recruit a Christian lady, I don't know. And we got talking about Christian theology. And as always, the Dawah team and the people who follow the Dawah script started off by telling me what I believe. I'm just thinking, shall we move away from him or can you hear me fine? Okay. So they started off by telling me what I believe. I believe in three gods, they said. So then I asked them, where in the Bible, do we agree that the Bible teaches that there's only one God? And they all said yes. And then I said, do we all agree that I believe in the Bible? And they all went yes. And then I said, so is it logical to assume that I won't believe in three gods? And they went no. And that's the cognitive dissonance of people who listen to the Dawah script. If you think like that, Muslim, you're not thinking, you're just repeating. If you're thinking, you will logically go, Bob believes in the Bible teaches one God, therefore Bob believes in one God. It's very logical, very simple. So then we went on to talk about the fact, we actually started by showing that the earliest Christians worship God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And I showed that through quoting the martyrdom of Polycarp. And as always, they wanted to ignore some words whilst listening to other words. And that's something you've got to watch out for. So then they started attacking the Trinity based on the implications of the Incarnation, which is exactly what Muslims do all the time. They ignore the doctrine of the Incarnation to attack the Trinity without recognizing that we Christians believe in the Trinity and the Incarnation. And all their criticisms of the Trinity are answered by a knowledge of the Incarnation.
that Christ in his humanity prayed to his Father, Christ in his humanity died, Christ in his humanity had limited access to his divine knowledge. Doesn't mean it wasn't there. So then we started talking a bit more about the Trinity, and they said, show me where Jesus says, I am God, worship me. John chapter 5, 22. Honor me as you honor the Father, so that all might honor the Son as they honor the Father. Muslims all agree that the Father is the equivalent to Allah. So you can replace the word Father with the word Allah. So Jesus is saying, honor the Son as you honor Allah, which means Jesus is God and worship him. And I asked the Muslims, I said, hold on a minute, would you honor Jesus as you honor Allah? They said, no. Why, I asked them. And they said, because he's not God. Which means that when Jesus says, honor me as you honor the Father, he is saying, I am God, worship me. Now, then they said, honor and worship are not the same word. And I had to give them a little English lesson in what the word prayer means and what the word worship means. Prayer means to make supplication, to ask someone to do something. Doesn't matter who you ask. The next thing is worship. We are skippy, worship means to give due honor. The word doxa in Greek means to give honor, to give divine glory, to give glory to God. So Jesus is saying, honor him, worship him, glorify him as you honor the Father. That only makes sense if Jesus is saying that he is God. So, brothers and sisters, if you're following the narrative of the Dawah team, you are being lied to. What you need to do is stop taking the snippet verses that you've learned from Golden Shower Hijab, Shamsi Gonzalez, I don't know my Trinity Hashim, or Mansour, show me where Jesus is the God of Israel, I am the first and the last. These are the things that you need to do. You need to study the Christian faith with knowledgeable Christians. If you want to talk to me, send me an email. btbsoco@gmail.com. Bravo Tango, Sierra Oscar, Charlie Oscar @gmail.com. I literally try to reply to every single person that writes to me, so correspondence is a bit slow, but I do eventually get around to replying to everybody, I hope. So study with Christians, and if you want, I'll set up a study group on Zoom specifically for Muslims.
Wow.
And we will study the Bible together. And all I ask you to do is just study it honestly. If you study it with me for a number of weeks and you're not convinced, fine. But at least be honest in studying what the scriptures say. It's not a hard thing to ask. So there you go. God bless.
God bless. Bob, praise the Lord.